All right, thank you so much for tuning back into another reaction video. My name is Chris.
My name is Sam. And
we are Offset
Era.
Woohoo!
Ha
ha! All right. As you've seen in the title, we're bringing back
Nemophila.
Yeah, it's been a while, man.
It has been quite a while.
They're like one of our OGs, you know, yeah, as far as the.
It was actually, show. I'm pretty sure it was the first Nemophila video that we reacted to was what really got the ball rolling in terms of, you know, viewers and subscribers. So
it did.
You know, we have an enormous amount of gratitude for that.
I believe that there is going to be a playlist, so you can check out any of their prior ones. And once you do that, let us know what you want to see from them. It's been a while. I know they've been putting out some new stuff, so just let us know what you guys want us to react to next, and we'll be happy to jump on that.
I think this is actually the first live video that we're going to react to.
So speaking of, we're checking out Change the World. It's an official live music video, or official live video on their actual page, on their actual YouTube channel. Only a month ago this was posted, so something fairly recent, so I'm glad to see that.
And a solid amount of views, 72,000.
Yeah, not too bad.
Not too bad at all.
And they have 276 comments. What do we got here?
Has anyone else noticed Saki let out what looks like a lion's roar to the crowd? Huge facial reaction near the end of her first solo, the one right after Haraguchi's bass solo. I love how passionate she gets when she plays. She was in a zone here. Just curious if anyone else noticed it. Time stamp to
150.
Yep, 150.
Okay, we'll check that out.
We'll have to keep, definitely keep that in mind. If they play near you, do yourself a solid and go see them live.
They are epic. Yes, of course, Saki and Hazuki's guitar playing is amazing, but Hira's bass is the best in this song.
Oh, I got something to definitely look forward to.
Hell yeah. Thank you, Nemophila, for the music yours of every Friday that takes away the stress in our lives. Very nice.
This has to be my new favorite song. Drumming, guitar, and vocals were top shelf.
Nice.
I like that phrase, top shelf.
Top shelf.
Top shelf, top drawer, top form.
Yes.
Can't wait to see them when they come to the States.
Yes. Great performance. Everything looks and sounds great, as per usual with Nemophila. Yeah, I would agree. So a lot of the stuff we've seen live for them was just like in a studio setting.
Yeah.
So I'm really excited to check this out, and I think we can go and jump into this one.
Yep, let's jump in.
Let's jump
with gusto. For anybody jumping with gusto for the very first time into the channel, welcome to the channel.
Welcome to the channel. As I mentioned before, we have a playlist for
Nemophila.
So if you want to check any of our prior reactions, do that, and then let us know what you want to see in the next one.
We got playlists for all the bands that we react to on a regular basis. We have a playlist for our original music.
Yep.
We got playlists for days.
Playlists galore. But if you're not new to the channel,
you know what time it is.
You know what time it is.
It's time for
the glorious
epic
transition.
Boom.
And here we are, Nemophila, Change the World official live video.
Let's do it.
Here we go. Very heavy guitars. What a stage setup. They're very far apart from each other.
They are.
Why is the bass player in a riser? That's weird. I mean, I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but it's just weird. They have all these little... Man, this is not fair. Can you imagine us? No wires trip over. We can just run around a stage.
Yeah.
Oh my God. It's not fair. No, this sounds good so far.
I make the best of it.
But no, this is incredible. Let's say it.
That is a hell of a stage.
Awesome.
I love the lights.
Yeah, the lights are crazy. Yeah, the bass is really thick.
Yeah.
Ooh, that roll!
Yeah!
Ooh, that fell!
Killer.
Ooh, that
that film.
I love their background vocals.
Yeah, they sound great.
Nice.
Yeah.
So I feel like we're going to hear a lot of awesome stuff. Just a comment on that. Looks like a pick player.
Yep.
I didn't see any slapping or finger picking. I think it's just straight primary pick picker. So not very. A lot of times you see some of these like, I think she wearing a System of a Down shirt.
I think she is.
I think the other singer is wearing one. The singer is wearing a System of a Down. System of a Down, awesome. I love how like Western music infiltrates.
Yes.
That part of the world. It's really interesting to see that. And I hear we're about to hear an amazing guitar part. So we're gonna rewatch this.
Yeah.
From here, I believe. She's like, yeah, and then like the light is on her. And the roll. Nice. Nice. It really sounds good with all of them singing at the same time.
Yeah.
Although, when they sing and they brought it all in, and that especially that last part, I don't know what it is, but it gives me like a nostalgia feeling to like watching like an intro, like to a like a cartoon.
Yeah,
like an anime, or like even like, I hate to say like a kid show or like a Barbie show or movie or something. It sounds like this would be like
about Barbie.
Yeah, but... no, it sounds Barbie-y because it's female, they're higher pitch. It's got more of like, I'm not saying that it sounds bad. It just sounds like something I would hear in a commercial setting.
It's accessible.
Yes,
there's an accessibility factor.
Yes, even. So like to me, there's nothing more accessible than cartoons, right? Saturday yeah. morning cartoons like that. That's yeah. just bringing me to that. I'm watching my favorite Saturday morning cartoon. This is the intro. This is the theme song. It just sounds like that for some reason to me. I don't know. That's just it's reaction. That's what you get. Oh my god, it spills! What a huge sound.
Yeah.
All right. Let's
save that for next time.
Yeah. All right. Let's flip back over. All right. That was Nima Fill Out with Change the World. Awesome. I love that. I would say that, like I said before, I feel like it's very accessible. Like when we first heard Nemophila, it was more like heavy, and she was more of kind of had more of like a gravel and like a sear to her voice. This like is still, way
still,
pop.
I mean, there's still some of that edge in there.
Yeah.
But it's
definitely veered to the poppy side, at least for this song.
Yeah, like that's not to say that they've completely done that with all their songs, but it's interesting to see the way that they go about that with this song. And
yeah,
you know, obviously the musicality is still there.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
The guitar solos were fantastic. The bass solo, you got me light up.
Yeah, I would say that the guitar solos to me were reminiscent of what I would see like classic guitar players play.
Yeah,
and not a lot of tapping or anything. A lot of just like hammer-ons and pull-offs, and a lot of just tremolo picking, which is just fast picking. And you saw that happening with everyone in this band.
And each of the guitars actually,
even the bass player,
each of the guitars also sounded very distinct. Like like they had their own distinct tones
and play style for sure.
Yes,
I feel like the guitar player that was playing with that big beautiful Ibanez, I feel like she could have been higher in the mix
a little bit.
When she played into her part, I was just like, hey, it's kind of quieter. But other than that, what she played was amazing. But yeah, in the vocals, the arrangement, the song itself, very poppy to me. Like I said, I would say like
in comparison to some of their more aggressive songs,
right? Exactly. And like I said, it gave me like a theme song that you would see in the 80s or something.
You get a sense of nostalgia from it.
Exactly.
That's really cool. When you feel nostalgia.
But I love that. They're great. They obviously know what they're doing. They're very proficient at everything that they do. And then vocal wise, I think everything was pitched the right way. There was no airiness or sour notes or anything like that. And I wouldn't expect that for something they put on their own channel. But yeah, amazing. I don't know if this was from a DVD, just to say.
Rising Nemo, 4th Anniversary Blu-ray.
Okay, so it is from a DVD. So that's why it sounds so good. Because I professionally produce this. So it makes more sense why that stage setup is so great.
Yeah.
Because they booked this and made this all about their DVD. So
yeah.
So I want to do that someday.
I want to make a DVD. Yeah, make a DVD.
Just show up and just have people doing it for you. All you do is you have to make sure you play the best possible performance and everything else. The lighting, the songs, the sound, the setup, all of that is done for you.
Yeah.
That would be so nice. All right. Anyway, that was our reaction to Nemophila.
Change the world.
That was great.
That was awesome.
We're very happy to check that out. We love Nemophila. Make sure you comment with what you want to see next from them, and we'll be happy to jump on something. Let's do some more live.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's add some live videos to the mix.
Yeah. You know,
if they're as fantastic as this, absolutely.
Absolutely. And maybe more from this even.
Yeah.
This, what is this? DVD.
Fourth anniversary.
So yeah, if you want us to check out some more from this, let us know.
Yep.
But we are Offset Era.
We are 2/3 of Offset Era, based out of sunny Southwest Florida.
All original pop.
All original punk core.
Punk core, yes.
You want to know what that means? Check out, we have a playlist of our original music.
Yep.
So you'll understand what I'm talking about.
Yep.
When you dive into it.
And we have a music video popping up at the end of this video called Watch It Burn.
Yep, check the first out. Single off of our new EP, A New Era.
Right.
That and 5 other songs, so for a total of 6 all original bangers.
Yep.
Very fun to play live.
Yep. And we have quite a bit of history, so if you go to our digital platforms, you'll see that there's quite a bit of music we've done over the years. Check it all out. It's all different. All has its own identity. So very proud of that. And we have some shows coming up.
That's right. Saturday, November 18th, we're going to be at Rackham Spirits and Times in Cape Coral, Florida.
Yep. Playing with Yabo Tribe, On the Fence, and some more bands to be announced. And once I have a flyer, I will post it here. But that's it. Thank you so much for commenting, subscribing, and letting us know what you want to see. And we'll see you in the next one.
Take care.
See ya.